Praise the Lord, everyone. This is Apostle Chauncey Craig of Discipling Ministries, the place where we're not concerned about a building, but the building of a people. And we welcome you to your midday manna. We thank you so much for calling in and being a part. And even if you didn't get a chance to call in, just know that these recordings are normally on the internet. You can go to YouTube under Chauncey Craig. You can go to Spreaker under Chauncey Craig, or you can go to our website, which is Discipling Ministries, KY, as in Kentucky, .org, all together, Discipling Ministries, KY.org, and you can find it under Food from a Raven. But anyway, just wanted to let you know, just in case, you know, you wanted to hear it again or you wanted to share it with someone. But today we're going to Romans 12. We're going back to Romans 12. We've been on the topic of act right. And this is actually be number three that we're talking about this particular thing of act right. Again, Romans 12, beginning at verse 9. It says, "Let love be without hypocrisy. Abhor what is evil. Cling to what is good. Be kindly affectionate to one another with brotherly love. In honor, giving preference to one another. Not lagging in diligence. Fervent in prayer. Serving the Lord. Rejoicing in hope. Patient in tribulation. Continuing steadfastly in prayer. Distributing to the needs of the saints. Giving to hospitality. Bless those who persecute you. Bless and do not curse. Rejoice with those who rejoice and weep with those who weep. Be of the same mind toward one another. Do not set your mind on high things, but associate with the humble. Do not be wise in your own opinion. Repay no one evil for evil. Have regard for good things in the sight of all men. If it is possible, as much as depends on you, live peaceably with all men. Beloved, do not avenge yourselves, but rather give place to wrath, for it is written, 'Vengeance is mine, I will repay,' says the Lord. Therefore, if your enemy is hungry, feed him. If he is thirsty, give him a drink, for in so doing, you will heap coals of fire on his head." Verse 21, "Do not be overcome by evil, but overcome evil with good." Amen. And once again, our subject area has been act right. And for those that haven't been with us, or just as a reminder, refresher, if you will, we've been talking about this thing because God has given me the word of reformation or restoration to the church, and that He's reforming, He's restoring the church. He's restoring, He's reforming His people. And when you look at that word reform, it means to make changes or to make straight, to make what is crooked, to make straight. And sometimes what we fail to realize is, you know, just because we go to church and just because we hear a word, because we pray, because we go through the ritualistic things of church, we feel like we're okay. But there's a greater need for us to draw nearer to Him, that He'll draw nearer to us and begin to reveal to us the direction to go, begin to reveal to us our purpose in life, and some areas where we need work. Amen? Because again, most of us, a lot of us get to a point where we say, "Well, I'm saved, I'm good." But I promise you, God is always working on us. He's always striving to push us to greater. He's always trying to push us to deeper depths, higher heights. And we can't just get comfortable saying, "I'm saved." Amen? So He's always restoring. He's always, He chastised. He's breaking away some rough edges. He's revealing some things about our character that we may not necessarily like. And sometimes we say that's the devil, when it's actually God revealing some stuff about our character. So there's in order to be reformed, amen, or the evidence of being reformed or restored to our rightful place is for us to act right. Amen? So once again, God can't come in and do something in our life and we stay the same. So these are some character traits that the writer is giving us. We've gone over a lot of this. I believe we left off on last Thursday right around, I want to say verse 14, about bless those who persecute you and bless and do not curse. And I think one of the things that we sometimes we fail to understand, or we fail to acknowledge, is that not everybody gonna like you. Amen. Not everybody gonna like me, and that's just the way it is. And sometimes people may not even know you and begin to persecute you, as we say, the backstabbers, begin to run down your name, or to say who you are, what you're not, and so forth and so on. But that's not for me to fight against. Amen. He says that I'm to bless them. He says, bless those who persecute you. Bless and do not curse. And sometimes we don't even know. Amen. But when the Holy Ghost revealed to us, amen, or allow that thing to come to pass, or even for them people, for those same people to come and apologize, to say, hey, I had you pegged wrong. What I heard about you ain't right. It's not for me to hold it against them, because, we had some lost time, or you thought this about me without even, but we're to forgive them. Amen. We're to let that thing go. Amen. We're to bless them. Hallelujah. Amen. Anybody got anything right there before we jump into the new? Bless those who persecute you. Bless and do not curse. Anybody? Amen. Amen. So let's pick up right here. Let's look at 15. It says, rejoice with those who rejoice and weep with those who weep. Remember, we're talking about act right. So it says, rejoice with those who rejoice and weep with those who weep. Amen. But when we look at this thing of rejoicing, sometimes when people, I just go back to the church. Sometimes when people testify or they give good news about what God is doing in their life, or they testify of his goodness, sometimes we'll clap our hands and be like, oh, praise the Lord. But then on the inside, or once we say, oh, praise the Lord, and act like we rejoicing, we really saying, well, I bet they did this. Well, I bet they did that. Well, they ain't really doing this. But he says, rejoice with those who rejoice. Rejoice with them. In other words, take an interest in it. Take a real interest in it. Let's not be so phony and fake. Amen. Let's not try to allow our minds to go places and think the bad things. But rejoice with those who rejoice. Take a genuine interest in it. Amen. Let's not do it with being grudging. Amen. Let's not do it, just because. But genuinely care, amen, that God is doing something in somebody else's life. Really, rejoice with them. Amen? Anybody got anything right there? Amen. But we're to rejoice with them. Amen. We're to rejoice. If they're rejoicing, we're to rejoice with them. Amen. We're to take it just as serious as they take it. Take it like it's yours. Be just as happy for them as we would for ourselves. Amen. But he goes on to say, he also says, and weep with them that weep. So he's going from a high to a low. He said, okay, well, if we can genuinely rejoice with someone, if we can yet be on the high, well, if somebody's on the low, if they're weeping, we should also do the same. Amen? We should have we should be genuinely being able to weep and to feel what they feel, to go through with them, to reap right there. I'm with you, sis. I'm with you, sis. Amen? I'm with you, brother. Amen. Now this ain't the type of, you heard me say before, about a pity party type thing. Amen. But, sometimes we've had people that have lost family members, that have gotten sick, or that certain things. Amen. That thing hurts. Amen. And most of us, have had someone around us, so we know what that feels like. Amen. And we can genuinely weep with them. Hallelujah. Amen. Well, again, we're talking about act right. Act right. If we're indeed going to be reformed, if we're indeed going to be restored to the place that God has taken us to, amen, there's a need to rejoice with those who rejoice and weep with those who weep. Amen. Let's look at 16. It says, be of the same mind toward one another. Be of the same mind toward one another. Be of the same mind toward one another. What was this? When we hear this type of word, Be of the same mind toward one another. Most of us would say, well, what does that mean? Or how can I possibly be of the same mind with somebody else? But all this is really saying is be in harmony. Be in harmony. Live in harmony. You know, live in one accord. Amen. Be in harmony. Be in harmony. In other words, we don't have to we don't have to be angry with or live an angry life. We don't have to downplay anybody else's achievement or anybody else or lift up their failures. But let's be at harmony. Let's be at harmony. Amen. Be of the same mind toward one another. What mind? The same mind that you would want to receive. Amen. You don't want anybody to beat you down. You know. Amen. But once again, that same mind. Be of the same mind toward one another. But it goes on to say, do not set your mind on high things. Do not set your mind on high things. And basically, what this thing is saying is, you know, when we look at it, it doesn't mean don't want greater. That's not what it's saying. But it is saying, don't be so anxious to be high that you do something illegal, amen. Because sometimes we want stuff so bad, or we even in the household of faith, amen. Even in the things of God, we'll try to steal somebody else's anointing. We'll try to steal somebody else's language or words or they tongues or whatever unlawfully. That's not yours, amen. Because we want to be so deep. We try to steal gifts. Hallelujah, amen. But don't do that kind of stuff. That's unlawful. Don't be so anxious to be high, amen. To be rich or powerful, that we doing stuff that we shouldn't be doing. Amen. Once again, let's look at it. It says, do not set your mind on high things. On high things. Don't set your mind there. Because sometimes we can set our mind or set our thoughts on stuff so high. And I'm talking about things now. Look what it said. High things. Amen. Rich. To be powerful, to have people to look. Don't set your mind on that type of stuff. But look what he says. He said, but associate with the humble. But associate with the humble. Amen. And when we hear that, it's telling us again, just like it says, to associate with the humble. Amen. And just go through life with as little show, as little flash and dash as possible. Amen. Some of you, when I say flash and dash, anything we get, amen, we're trying to flaunt it. We're trying to, it's okay. I'm telling you, it's okay to have stuff. If you know me, you know I like nice things. Amen. I like nice things. Amen. But those things don't make me. Amen. They don't determine who I am. I don't do it to be showy or flashy. Amen. In fact, to be completely honest, sometimes it embarrasses me if somebody asks me about something that, you know, worldly stuff, or I say, you know, just things. Amen. That don't make me. Amen. What about this word in me? Ask me about that. You know, ask me about my day before you ask me about my watch. You know what I'm saying? I hope you understand. Amen. But what I'm getting at is, again, it says, but basically, to walk low in life, he says, but associate with the humble. But associate with the humble. In other words, walk underneath. Walk underneath. We don't have to walk like everybody else is beneath us. Amen. Even though God has blessed us with some things, with some stuff, there are things that we just like. And God has allowed us to obtain some stuff. Amen. So, but again, don't let the stuff make you. Amen. Don't let the stuff put you above anybody else or make you feel like you're above anybody else. Amen. But walk low. Walk low. Walk humble. Any questions or comments right there?
Okay. I would like to say, we have to be in the Lord to to be able to do this, because we can't, if you look at it, it's not normal circumstances. I'll put for somebody that's not in the Lord. Because you can try to do a lot of things, but we have to be in the Lord in order to do this, because I know that we all know that they are not normal circumstances.
Amen.
Because if we are not in the Lord and we're not allowing the Lord to teach us, you can want to do a lot of things, and you can do it for a while. But like I say, if we don't listen to the Lord and allow the Lord to teach us, you'll go back to your old self. I'll say go back to the old man, but as long as we allow God to teach us, we can do it. And as long as we listen to God, we can do it.
Amen. Praise God. Praise God. You're right about it. You write about it. Anybody else? Thank you.
I know that earlier this morning you talked about building relationships. And I see a connection with what you're saying now, with what you said this morning, because in order to develop relationships, you have to have holy discernment. If you're going to walk with other people in lowliness, you have to have godly discernment in order to do that. I know that we can walk with those who weak. We can do that, but we have to develop a relationship with that person and develop a relationship with God. And that just does not happen overnight. It is a process, and like the lady said a minute ago, it's something that has to you have to know God in order to do it, but it also means that you have to spend time with the Lord, spend time with the Word, try the Word, and see how it fits on you, and ask for a holy discernment.
Amen. Amen. Agreed. Thank you. Anybody else?
I just want to say that we're living in a time where there's competitiveness, and it's hard to rejoice with someone when I am competing with you. You know, if you got something I wanted, or I got to get something better than what I think you got, so when you do get something, it's hard for me to rejoice with you. And so, you know, that's why the Word come to remind us to rejoice with those that rejoice and genuinely rejoice. And we need to understand that we hold up our own blessings when we fail to do the things like the Word says to rejoice when other people are rejoicing. You're holding up your own blessings. I cannot expect the Lord to bless me when I'm so envious and I'm so competitive with you. I might as well stop looking for anything to really come unless I actually have the monies to go and get it. And a lot of us don't have the monies to get some of the things that we want. So we have to depend on God. And when you have to depend on God, you need to keep your avenue from the throne to you. You need to keep that clear. And it has to be kept clear out of love and thankfulness and a good attitude.
Amen. It's really good. Thank you. Thank you. You're right. Amen. Anybody else? Amen. Praise God. Praise God. But once again, we're talking about act right. Act right. And just to add to everything else that was being said, you know, she said to rejoice with those who rejoice and weep with those who weep. In verse 16 says, be of the same mind toward one another. Once again, I talked about harmony, but it says, do not set your mind on high things, but associate with the humble. Amen. And But right there, if you think about it, normally we end up in two places. We end up in two places. As it says, to set your mind on high things. So let's say we end up in the high things because we set our mind there. When we end up in the high things, in other words, we end up on the, you know, socially we end up, you know, in the higher class. What happens is because we're in the higher class, we're only going to associate with the higher class, or we're going to go down to the lower class and flaunt or show off. Rarely is there an up there. Is there someone? Do we walk in the place of humility? Again, in the to take the low road. Yeah, I may be accomplished right here. Yeah, I may be established right here. But I'm still amongst my brethren. Even if they of low estate. Amen. Because again, let's just keep it real. When you look around the church, amen, you find most of the high rollers are the ones that got it going on. Where do you find them at? Normally, you find them hanging out in the same in the same ministry. Well, you know, especially if they of the same denomination. Amen. You find them hanging out in the same place. Why? Because that's their you know, socially that's their kind. But rarely do you find someone that's well-to-do that's going to come over here and hang out at your little storefront or your little hole in the, as they say, your little hole in the wall church. You know, why? Because that's not what we do. So once again, and if they do, it's normally because everybody, every time they come in, they love when somebody say, oh, man, you got a new suit. Oh, man, you got this, you got that. But I can't speak for everybody, but that embarrasses me. That embarrasses me, and that's why, you know, I tend to dress low, I tend to walk low, because, again, I don't want to be known by that, you know, but I bless God that he's blessed me, you know, and I just feel with some, that he's blessed me beyond measure, amen. I'm not rich, but I'm rich in Christ, amen, but it still embarrasses me, amen, when it comes to stuff, hallelujah. So, again, he's saying, verse 16, be of the same mind toward one another. Do not set your mind on high things. Amen. I'm not set right there on the high things, but I'm associated with the humble. Amen. I can fit in right here. Right here. Amen. I'm good. Right here. Amen. It goes on to say, do not be wise in your own opinion. Do not be wise in your own opinion. In other words, don't be conceited. Don't be conceited. Don't think yourself more wise or more above than anyone else. Amen. Don't be vain. Amen. Questions or comments right there. Amen. Anybody got anything they want to share? We're right about our timeline, so I don't want to keep it going. Amen. But again, we're talking about act right, people of God. There are some godly characteristics that we have to take on. And as Sister Darlette was letting us know, amen, that this thing comes with a relationship with Christ. Amen. Because if in order to obtain this newness, in order to take off that old life and put on the new, amen, in order to really do these things, because if not, you know, the flesh will have us do some things that are outside of Christ. So that's why we have to walk in the Spirit. In order to walk in the Spirit, we got to have a relationship with God. So in order to do these things, to take on this godly characteristic, for it to become who we are and not just something that we do from time to time, but for it to become who we are, there's a need for us to be, again, to be restored, to be reformed to our rightful place, amen? And when that's done, we can do this stuff naturally. It becomes a part of us and not something that we necessarily have to be looking to our left and, am I doing this right? That's a hard way to live. But to know that Christ lives, that this thing is a part of me. He's in me. This is who I am. It becomes a lot easier. Amen? Act right. Act right. Act right.